Let me out! Let me out! No, it's not that bad. Honestly, it's this wood, not a real deal. Moving house, and I've got to get all my stuff sort of cleared up, and I want to leave this place looking a little bit nicer, so a little bit cleaning. Good for the soul, they say. Oh, and by the way, there is a couple of things that does this look weird? A couple of things I want to talk to you about today. We'll get. And if you want to give me a hand, just call on me. That'd be great. One of the things I want to talk to you about today is that I've got, it's not my channel, it's a friend of mine called Sharon. She does a channel on Facebook called Sharon Ford. It's a channel that I was following. She has autoimmune stuff going on as well, and I used to watch all her videos and stuff that she'd done, and little messages and her thoughts and stuff that she put up. Found it interesting, and there was one day she was just doing a video with her phone and stuff up, and today. Right now, where you're sitting is right on the stairs, so if you fall, you go, okay? There we go. But yeah, so Sharon is doing her video. She's just there with her phone doing it, you know, in Instagram style, you know, facing upwards of vertical style and whatnot. And I just thought, you know, she's onto something. She's really good at what she's doing. And perhaps with what I can bring to the table, we could work together. So I brought the cameras, editing skills, and stuff like that there. And she brought her knowledge, and the fact she's got a great personality and is brilliant in front of the camera. So that all helped. So I'm doing a thing with her, and it's strange how well our chemistry actually works. There's been a lot of people saying that you look really good on camera together, and it works, it's seamless, you know, like we banter off each other very well. And sometimes that happens whenever you're working with people. I used to work in radio, and there are certain people that you can just click with, and the bounciness and the to and fro and everything just works. There's other people I worked with in radio, and we struggled, and we both of us knew it wasn't as if it was a big shocker or it was one-sided or anything. It was just we knew that we'd been in the profession long enough that we knew that what we were doing is just, we weren't the same sense of humour and stuff like that there. It just didn't work. But what me and Sharon are doing really works. It seems to reach out. A lot of people seem to get help from it, if it's even just the fact that it's made them laugh for a day. That's all that matters. You have an autoimmune disease of some description, or perhaps you know somebody who has, I might find it helpful. Go and check out our Sharon at Ford page on Facebook. Again, I'm working with Sharon on this. It's not my idea. It's Sharon's, but we keep on saying, oh, it's not my idea. It's kind of both of our ideas, I guess, but it's Sharon's baby. So yeah, we've got the whole moving house thing that's going on, so I wanted to tell you about that. I wanted to tell you about the stuff I'm doing with Sharon, which we're actually really looking forward to a lot of the stuff. We've been in contact with a few other businesses and people who do nutrition and yoga and stuff like that there. So maybe work with them. Why am I so out of breath today? It is so hot, it's absolutely ridiculous. But it was my old bedroom, which I don't want to show you too much of. There's not much left of it here, but this was my view, which I kind of will miss, I have to admit. Yeah. It's pretty nice. So, just a little quick one about some stuff. I am so out of breath, I'm so unhealthy. I think that's what it is. Look, my hair's a mess. I'm cleaning up stuff. I'm getting stuff ready. This is not a glamorous vlog by any stretch of the imagination. But I just want to say, I'll be back again shortly. If I'm on a little bit of a break at the minute, it's because I'm moving house. It's because I'm trying to get stuff done. I'm going to have to get internet and stuff into the new house. I will video it and stuff. It just might be late of it going up, if you know what I mean, because obviously I'm going to need an internet line and whatnot to make sure I can upload. Why am I? Whew! Hot! Oh, and one other thing before I go. I don't know if anybody else watched this or not, but the Great Hack that was on Netflix, and still is on Netflix, all about the Cambridge Analytica and Facebook and Google. And in fact, it's basically about your identity and how it's used and how it's shared. And I've always kind of known about this sort of thing. I guess we all kind of have, about how our data can be used to sort of get those adverts and everything in front of our eyes.
But whenever you go into it and watch The Great Hack, and you see just exactly how much information that these guys are storing on you, and the fact that somebody was along for the ride and asked Google if we can have this information, and or Facebook if they can have this information, Facebook has seemed to have said yes. And then this company was basically just using this information to manipulate our feelings, and that's the scary thing. I think it's a subject that I'd love to go into more. I just don't know if you guys would be interested in it or not, but if you are, leave a little comment down below and tell me if you've seen this sort of thing. Tell me if you're worried about who sees your online data and how much of it that they're seeing, and have you been sort of hacked before? Has an app sort of, have you noticed an app intruding in on what you may think is personal data that it shouldn't be looking at? That sort of thing. Do let me know, because I find it absolutely fascinating. It's one of those things, because a lot of the time now we're always asked, even to get coffee. I don't have one of the cups about at the minute, but there's the local sort of coffee that we all get, the fast coffee that we get here now. I'll not mention their names, but even for them, it's all about your data. If you wanted to get there, you know, like another way you would usually get a little stamp, you could buy 8 coffees and the 9th is free or whatever it is. They do the same thing, but you have to register with them. You have to give them your email address, you know, to be able to get that. And that little bit of information, if you give them their email address, they can get so much more from that as well, because once they have your email, chances are your email account's going to be linked to Instagram, Facebook, Snap, all those things. And so they can then sort of look into those. And not only that, if it's on an app, that app can now look at your contacts, find all them, and then send them emails too. I think it's something that needs to be looked in a little bit further by the governments and whatnot, that data use and data information about us is, well, it should be part of our human rights. People shouldn't just be allowed to lift it and then use it to manipulate advertising. I have nothing against the fact that these companies were doing stuff for advertising, that's great, but the thing is, if we see advertising somewhere, it's the same advert that everybody else will see, and we get to judge on that one advert. Whereas with Cambridge Analytica, they were able to make ads for you. They knew what you liked, they knew what you feared, they knew what would get you emotionally attached to a subject. All that information is being stored, and they then can use that to make the perfect ad for you. So if you were sitting and you didn't know you were going to vote left or vote right, if you were sitting there, they could manipulate that so that they could have you vote the way they wanted. You know, they'll tell you yes, but it's still your final decision. But advertising works. We've talked about this before on the channel. Advertising is can work very well, and it can get stuck in your brain. Just by that, remember, just by me doing that, already you're already thinking about going and getting a burger and a coffee, you know. So it's one of those things. I do want to talk about it more. I've probably talked about it too much already. Let me know down below if you want me to talk about this subject. If you haven't watched The Great Hack on Netflix, and if you haven't got Netflix, go around to somebody who has, go and watch it. It's fascinating and scary. Came in here for something. Tea.